back on Big Country with CCMA award winner Tenille Townes.
That's
Tenille,
so weird.
Oh, hey, you're gonna hear it a lot more. Let me tell you. We need to talk about this humongous event coming up tomorrow night. Big Hearts for Big Kids at the Tar Center at Evergreen Park. How are things shaping up this year?
It looks so good out there. I cannot believe it's been 10 years. What's crazy is it really has blown my mind every single year because people just keep showing up. And I know I'm biased because I'm from here, but I love getting to tell this story everywhere I go.
Big Hearts for Big Kids, it's been an opportunity, not just as a fundraiser for us that ensures that our operations are good and strong, but it allows us to create more awareness. You know, when we look back to, you know, the very first Big Hearts, the night of that, our board president had to walk in and say, we closed the doors today. But instead of saying, okay, we're all done, looked at it as an opportunity, okay, how do we fix this?
Tenille at school could not understand why there were some kids that couldn't go home. And they decided, could I put a benefit concert together to help them with that house? And she was 13 then or whatever. In reality, that's exactly what has happened.
It's a crazy thing to think back to 10 years ago when we started this. You know, my mom would drive me around these downtown streets with a sponsor package, and we'd invite people to the show, and we were so excited that people showed up and that they wanted to be a part of this. And I mean, the night of our first event, the shelter doors had to close down because of lack of funding. And that night we raised $30,000, and I was like, wow, if this is what music can do, and if this is what this town can do, I never ever want to stop this.
What's the total as of this year? Do you know what it is?
And we've raised just over $1.5 million in 9 years walking.
That's incredible.
Tomorrow night. And what's even crazier is that there have been over 12,000 heads on pillows, like check marks of a kid sleeping in a bunk, which
wow.
is pretty crazy.
I did not know that number, so hearing that really...
Yeah.
Really makes it strike home for sure.
It does, and these are kids in the high school hallways around here. These are kids who are neighbors and friends, and it's pretty amazing that we get to kind of, as a whole community, wrap our arms around that Sunrise House and lift it up for people to know that it's there to turn to. Welcome to Grande Prairie. Yay! Hi. Welcome to my homeland.
I'm so excited.
We made it.
So
we're here.
Already.
Hi. How are you? Good to have you. Hi.
How are you?
How's it going?
Good.
I'm so happy you all made it. Yay.
We all love Tenille. She's just the kind of person, like, if Tenille asks you to do anything, you kind of just say yes. People are drawn to her just because of her positivity and her heart and her kindness. And so, like, whatever she's involved in, like, people just kind of want to be involved.
Mm-hmm. We're going to see you guys before lunch at the Sunrise House.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And the cause is just so great. Like, what they're raising money for and what they're doing here is just so awesome. We couldn't not be a part of it. So.
Yeah. Yeah, no, we're honored more than anything. Yeah.
Okay. Good night, everybody.
All right, go to bed.
Hey, we'll see you tomorrow.
Sleep well.
Yay! Okay, let's do this. Come on in, everybody.
Lead the way.
Well, welcome to the Sunrise House.
How's it going?
Hey.
I'm Matt.
Jody.
Nice to meet you.
Jody hey. Chad.
Hi, I'm Tanya.
Sunrise House opened for the first time in 2003 after it was recognized by a group of concerned individuals that there was possibly homeless youth in our city. So they came together and opened up this house. So this is the original house where it all started.
Good morning. How's it going?
Good. So good to see you.
It's such a good day. It's here.
Funding was a struggle for a long time, and then in 2010, the shelter actually had to close for about 10 months. That's when Big Hearts for Big Kids started. And since then, we've had over 12,000 bed nights and seen 1,000 kids or so. So it's a busy little building.
You know, when I look back on that very first Big Hearts, I'd been on the board for a little while and we're struggling trying to figure out why are we having trouble with funding? And it really was our growing community. People just weren't understanding that the issue was real and that we could possibly have kids on the streets. And that first Big Hearts played such a huge role in just creating the awareness that the issue was there, getting the community behind it, and instead of, you know, looking at it that these kids created their own problem, they're realizing all the struggles these kids are actually going through, and that when they show up here, it's because they're reaching out for help, you know? Again, tonight we're gonna have a packed room with people supporting and wanting to be a part of the solution.
You know, that in itself is so impactful. People forget that there's real stories, there's real trauma, and there's real hurt these kids are living with, and this is people's opportunity to be a part of it and to support that. Because of our community and events like this, we have not turned away one youth in the last 10 years. Every youth has walked out with a bag of lunch or a backpack, and kids will stay here anywhere from a couple of days, sometimes for a month. It just really depends on the circumstances that are bringing them in and how much work needs to happen to move them on. We really try to get things in place so that when they leave, they have what they need, and that we kind of become a last resort instead of a first.
Sometimes it just starts with, they just need to know that somebody cares.
Yeah.
That somebody actually cares about them.
Yeah, a little bit of support and guidance can go a long, long ways.
And it'd be interesting to see what trajectory they would have gone on without that little bit of support. So it's amazing what you guys do.
Yeah. It's amazing what you do. This is a pretty special home right here.
We'll be doing a writer's round all together. Tenille was cool enough to ask.
We're all songwriters here, so, you know, in case you haven't noticed, we live on inspiration. So I was a fan of what she was doing. I thought it was a great idea. But when I got here and saw it with my own eyes, totally get it.
Mm-hmm. Tenille, she's a champion for us. She sees that what we're trying to do here is bigger than all of us. And she's really become that strong voice for us and that person that can really help to get that message out. And people feel her passion for us. And it's so obvious. And when she meets our kids, it's so obvious that this is truly something that she loves. And it's just, it's incredible for us.
Go for some lunch, and then we'll be sound check, and we'll get to do the show, and I'm so excited!
She was never afraid to jump in the car and say, I need to go and see these people, and get them to buy into this whole thing.
She just has a real love for life, and people see it, and they fall in love with that, and who doesn't want to follow that?